That's the scene at the moment in New Zealand. Hopes of finding survivors beginning to fade now. Today, we're learning stunning new details from members of a U.S. delegation in Christchurch at the time, the moment the deadly ground shook. Former Indiana Senator Evan Bayh was with his wife at the time. He was attending a trade forum. She was shopping in a different part of the town. Back in Washington now. Senator, good morning to you. You were separated for 4 hours. Do you think you lost your wife?
Well, Bill, I didn't know. And at the beginning, obviously I was a little worried, but I thought the chances of her being killed or seriously injured weren't high. But as I walked toward the center of the city, it got progressively worse, and you could see that there was substantial damage. And then at one point, the real scary moment was when one of my companions got a text message saying that our hotel had been abandoned, had been cleared out, and that there had been many fatalities. And at that point, of course, I got worried. But thank God everything, at least for our family, turned out okay.
I could only imagine. You said that you dove under a boardroom table or some sort of big table, and your wife was taken by the owner of a store she was in. He grabbed her by the collar to get her outside.
Yeah, she had the worst of it. She was down in the historic district, which was really the epicenter of the whole thing. And the owner of the store that she was in literally grabbed her by the neck and threw her out into the street, and then went back in to get some other patrons out. And then out in the street, apparently it was just chaos, and there was even one woman who had been crushed by a piece of falling building there. So it was kind of traumatic for her.
Oh, I'm sure it was. And what did it feel like? What did you see? Because I'm certain you come home with memories that were just an absolute a nightmare.
Bill, it's hard to, if you hadn't been through an earthquake, which I'd never been through an earthquake, it's hard to describe. You know, you think, well, the earth moves and so what? But the building that I was in, it was like made out of paper. It was just being shaken really back and forth. Things were falling, even though I never felt like my life was in danger. But you could see huge buildings just collapse, the fronts of them gone. Obviously, that cathedral there, a terrible tragedy. And all the things you think you can rely on, including the very ground you're standing on, these buildings that were constructed to protect us suddenly become your enemies, you know, potentially hazardous. And so, and then the aftershocks, one every 15, 20 minutes, that was pretty serious. People wondering about, some traumatized, thousands out in the park, nowhere to go, couldn't go home, no electricity, no drinking water, that kind of thing. It was like the scene, a scene out of a disaster movie, only in this case, it was real.
I'm certain. Our best to those people down there trying to recover, too, and the search
Absolutely.
Continues for life. I'm certain they will find a few more people buried in the rubble. Let's hope they get to most of them before it is too late. Best to Susan, your wife, Senator.